Hey, what's up? I've been running every single day for the month of February. That's right, every single day. 28 days in a row. I ran fast, I ran slow, I ran very slow. I ran far-ish and I also ran not so far-ish. And all along the way, I learned some pretty valuable things, certainly to me, which I would like to share with you. So I'm gonna run upstairs, I'm gonna get tidy, and then we could talk about some of the things that I learned from running one entire month, 28 days in a row. Yo, what's up everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Come for the FPV and stay for the rather random running content. So I've been running for the last 28 days, every single day for 28 days, and I've learned a hell of a lot. Some of those things I think would apply to you, and I don't think you need to be a runner at all. You don't think you need to like running or even consider taking part in something like this. But I think some of the things that I've learned will definitely apply to your life. So let's get started. It's not about how far you run. It's just about getting out the door. Now, by far the most valuable thing I learned from running every single day this month is that it's all about just starting. Now, I'm no runner myself and I definitely did not enjoy running every single day, but I can say from doing it every single day that the most important thing that you can do is get out the door and do it. And why I think this applies to life and to other things is there's probably lots of things in your life that you should be doing or that you want to do, and all you really need to do is start. It takes a single step and two steps and three steps and four steps together, and all of a sudden you're on a walk or you're on a run. So that's probably the most important thing I learned during this whole time period is it doesn't matter about distance, it doesn't matter about speed, it doesn't matter about how many, it just matters about getting out the door and actually doing it. And I think we can all agree that this applies to far more things than just running. Ice baths are great. Now stay with me here. After every single run, I jumped in an ice bath for about 10 to 15 minutes every single day, and it gave me time for me to consolidate and summarize how I was thinking and how I was feeling. It gave me time to myself, and specifically during that time I was doing something that was going to help me continue what I chose to do, what I chose to get out the door to do. Now, I think this applies to life in so much as I think it's very important for you to take time to look after yourself, take time to do the things that will allow you to keep doing the things that you want to do. Now, you can read that in whatever way you choose, but most importantly, take from this that there are going to be things that you need to do, sacrifices that you need to make, pains and discomforts that you need to go through to allow you to do the thing that you want to do. So whether that's, you know, spending every 15 minutes before bed reading because it'll help you get ahead of those people in your class or the people in your industry, or if it's waking up early to open the newspaper or watch the news, whatever it is, those are the things we don't necessarily want to do, but you should do them because it'll help you get to where you want to go. Take the time to do the things that help you move and continue to move in the right direction, regardless of the pain and the discomfort that they cause you. Music is cheating. Staying motivated is obviously very difficult, and I used music every single day of the 28 days along my run because I didn't have anybody else with me and I needed something to keep me motivated. But in hindsight, looking back, I think that was completely the wrong thing to do, and I had wished that I didn't listen to the music and built up that mental fortitude to keep myself motivated, because that skill that you can learn of keeping yourself motivated will keep you going for the rest of your life. You know, the Kanye's and the Akon's and the tunes that keep you going during the runs, and the Eminem's and all those songs that you love to listen to, those are the things that motivate you. Those shouldn't be the things that motivate you. What should motivate you is you, what's inside here and the things that you're striving to do. So give up those aids that help you make things easier. Now, I'm not saying you should do away with the aids that allow you to do something. I'm saying do away with the aids that make everything easier. And I think you'll be a hell of a lot better for it. Running is really hard, but we're made to do it, so you will get used to it. So running is obviously hard on the body, but there's sufficient evidence to show that you, like me, were once born to run, and like anatomically we're not so different than we were when we were runners per se. Now, I don't want to get into all the science and all that stuff behind it, but what I'm trying to say here is that we are enormously and incredibly adaptive to whatever we're doing, us as human beings. So, like running, if you put your mind to something, you most certainly will adapt and overcome it. So, I am certainly no runner, but I ran every single day. And towards the end of it, I became really used to being out and actually thrived by being out there. And now I kind of miss being out there after having, you know, a couple days off. So basically what I'm trying to say is, don't be afraid to do things that you're not good at or you don't know how to do, because your body will adapt, you will adapt. Anything you try for the first time and commit to doing will be hard, at least for the large majority of us, whether that's picking up maths and science, that's hard in the beginning. Whether that's learning how to read and write, that's definitely hard in the beginning. Whether it's taking up a new sport, that's definitely hard in the beginning. But we are incredibly good at adapting. So what I'm trying to say is keep going, because you'll get better at it and that will bring you enjoyment and will hopefully help you keep moving towards that goal that you want to achieve. Like running, whatever it is you choose to do, with practice and patience, you will most certainly become good at it, because we humans are incredibly good at adapting and learning. So just keep going. I really enjoy the challenge, and to be honest, I might keep going. Now, that's coming from someone who absolutely despises running, and to be honest with you, I absolutely despise the running part of this challenge. But what I think I'm going to continue to do is I'm going to continue to challenge myself. And when I say that, I don't mean I'm going to run every single day for the remainder of this year. I think that would be an enormous challenge. But what I mean by that is I'm going to make sure I'm always challenging myself, because especially in times like these where we're cooped up and inside, we need something to keep us going. We need a challenge. We need something to keep us motivated. And I'm not talking about Akon. So I might run, I might lift weights, I might start reading all the time. The things that I know I should do, but I don't do because I'm lazy, I'm tired, I couldn't be asked. Those are the things I'm going to pick up and start doing. So I guess running is kind of like life. It's tough and full of challenges, and it requires you to put your best foot forward if you want to keep moving forward at the same pace. It's something that you were born to do. You are capable of whatever it is you choose you want to do. With patience and practice and some grit, you really can do anything. I hope these words, these messages, and this motivation finds you well, so that you can get up, get out the door, and find whatever version of this challenge is waiting for you. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye-bye.